board, staff and volunteers, welcome to the 2016 Hats Off to Excellence Awards Gala and Fundraiser.
My job is to keep everything going and make sure the appropriate people get acknowledged. We also get to eat food tonight. So, before we go any further, I want to acknowledge all of the awards finalists tonight because they all deserve recognition for the fantastic job they've done this year. It's my privilege to invite the representative of our presenting sponsor forward to bring greetings and remarks. Please welcome Tom Corsi, South Delta resident and Vice President Real Estate with Port of Vancouver.
Tonight, Teresa and I and several of my Port colleagues are proud to be here to join you tonight to recognize local business, local volunteers, and outstanding citizens. So congratulations to all the nominees for the work that you do to make Delta such a vibrant community.
Okay, here we go. Angus is going to read out the auction items. I think they're on page 3 of your booklet that's on your table. So we've only got five auction items tonight. We're going to get through that. And Angus is going to read out each item. I'll auction them off, and we'll raise some money here for the Chamber of Commerce. Okay, Angus, let's go with sold it way in the corner at $1,200.
Hey!
Sold it right your way at $850. $850. Sold it right down there for $3,500. Thank you. Sold it to that gentleman for $1,900. Thank you.
Our first award is the Volunteer of the Year Award, sponsored by Delta Cable. It is now my pleasure to invite Tanis Goodfellow, the representative of Delta Cable, to the podium to provide some information about the award.
Delta Cable is thrilled to continue our long-standing support of the Hats Off to Excellence Award and to present the 2016 Volunteer of the Year Award. This award recognizes an exceptional individual in our community who has volunteered significant time and effort to a Delta-based organization or organizations and has made a highly positive impact that has served to make our community stronger. And this year's three finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Volunteer of the Year. Carol Lefebvre at the Tuason Arts Center. Carol has won awards for theatrical directing, acting, and several technical categories. She founded the Sidekick Players almost 2 decades ago. They perform here now and are active in the community. Carol has mentored young people who've gone on to greater things in theater. She's been a director with Delta Assist, active in Kin Village, the Parks Recreation and Culture Commission, and was president of Theater BC. Carol Lefebvre is finalist for Volunteer of the Year. Bob Taggart is doing what he's always doing, helping someone. Here he's assisting Delta Assist. This may be just 5 or 10% of the groceries that will go out this year, sorted into hundreds of Christmas hampers. This takes months of assembling groceries, then a big push the week before Christmas. And this is just a small part of what Bob does. If you look in at the Ladner Legion, he's famous for helping the Hospice Society, Meals on Wheels, Veterans Care Homes, the May Days Parade. Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Taggart. For a cyclist, there are gaps. It can be difficult to ride your bike everywhere. Sometimes the rules of the road for cyclists are ambiguous. Some places you can easily ride to. Other times you have to take a longer route. Delta Hub Cycling Committee, students, commuters, seniors, and recreational riders have become the voice for cyclists, working with decision makers at City Hall and with others. He had only a bike and a bus pass when he returned to this region to work. Patrick Thompson is a Tuason resident and the founder of Delta Hub Cycling. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Volunteer of the Year.
Thank you, whoever nominated me. I haven't got a clue. I just want to say that I've been volunteering for just a little over 50 years now, A lot of things. I first started out stuffing envelopes for the old CCF party, which is now NDP. A long time ago, my dad hooked me into that when I was 12. So it has been a very long time. I've really enjoyed time with Delta Sist as well, and with Kin Village. They are two organizations that I also have volunteered with and sat on their boards. I just really want to thank all the members of the different boards that I've sat on. They, whew, out of breath. I've learned so much from them, and it's been a real honor to work with every single person in Toronto, and especially here for 30 years here. So I just want to thank everybody, and enjoy the night. Surprise!
The second award of the evening is the Employee Extraordinaire of the Year Award. This award is sponsored by MK Delta Lands Corp, or Lands Group, sorry. It is my pleasure to invite Teresa Cooper to the podium to provide some information about the award.
Good evening, everyone. MK Delta Lands Group is pleased to be the sponsor of the 2016 Hats Off to Excellence Employee Extraordinaire of the Year Award. This award is meant to recognize an outstanding employee of a Delta-based organization who has been recognized by their employer as having displayed strong leadership and having made a significant impact in their organization. They promote teamwork, go above and beyond, have a winning attitude, and leave a highly positive impression on those they meet. And I have met some of those through being the sponsor over the last few years, and they all truly are extraordinary. This year's three finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Employee of the Year. Gordon Food Service. GFS trucks deliver food across British Columbia. So we asked President Dana Dunnage to try out the inside sales chair she once occupied 19 years ago. Over the years, she rose in the company as she pursued her education. She used her people skills to get the best for her business. Then last year, a winner of the Top 40 Under 40 in Vancouver. From the inside sales desk to the first female president and youngest president ever of this now billion-dollar company. Steve Perry was once a heavy-duty mechanic himself before he got his master's, and he knows what is required to train mechanics. BCIT knew he knew. They were convinced that he was the guy to build and run the new Motive Power Center on Annecy Island. His center encourages industry partnerships, has lots of research projects on the go, but he still likes getting into a classroom whenever he can. They also train people to work on big ship engines. Canada's best heavy mechanic training facility, pretty much built and run by Steve Perry. Sue Zitnik seems to do just about everything and stays calm under pressure. While the shop is recycling mattresses, she's the office administrator, handles logistics, advertising things on Craigslist, or recycling things.
So when you're putting this on, you need to...
She's the company safety person, does the orientations and training, as staff has quadrupled. No wonder she's Employee of the Month, over and over and over again. The owner says she doesn't worry when she's away, because Sue Zitnik can take care of things. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Employee of the Year.
And the winner of the 2016 Employee Extraordinaire of the Year Award is Dana Dunnage. Well, thank you so much, and I will keep it to 1 minute. I do want to say congratulations to the two other finalists. You looked amazing up there, so... this award is for all three of us, and I thank you so much tonight. Thank you.
And for our next award, it's the Special Events and Tourism Award. This is sponsored by Delta Visitor Center. It is now my pleasure to invite Louise Wesselberger. Is that bad? Louise! Member Relations and Visitor Service Manager for the Delta Chamber of Commerce and Delta Visitor Center to the podium, please.
Delta Chamber of Commerce operates the Delta Visitor Center, and on behalf
of our year-round visitor servicing operation, it's my pleasure to present this wonderful 2016 Hats Off to Excellence Special Events and Tourism Award. This award recognizes a Delta organization or individual that has exhibited excellence in attracting and servicing visitors and residents in Delta through key events or initiatives. They've also exemplified effective marketing and quality product or service delivery that has contributed to the image, attractiveness, and sustainability of Delta. Exciting. With great experiences in Delta. And this year's three finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for special events and tours. The concept is to take the artwork off the wall and show it to people. The Delta Studio Stomp. Artists would put their work on display, not just one location. There were 7 or 9 places where artists displayed what they had done to help the Delta Hospital Foundation. The brochure told people where. And the name? They didn't want to conflict with the Vancouver Crawl, so it became the Delta Studio Stomp. The Jog for the Bog, held in July on International Bog Day, a day to celebrate local bogs and raise awareness of how they help reduce climate change. People from as far away as Texas and Australia came to run this year. There were both 5K and 10K runs, and proceeds helped the Burns Bog Society protect the ecological integrity of Burns Bog. The Rotary Club folks were ready. The cars were new, many sponsored by local businesses, many built by drivers' families. And the Derby was underway. It was for kids ages 9 to 13, over 40 cars competing. Thousands were there. The event made the national news. Proceeds would support many Rotary Club events. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Special Events and Tourism 2016.
And the winner of the 2016 Special Events and Tourism Award is Delta Stomp.
Thank you very much. I looked at the other two and I thought, there's just no way, with a program that's geared towards kids and then a program that's encouraging people to get involved in the bog. To me, those are very, very worthy people to be competing with and considered with. I'd like to thank the artists and the artisans in North Delta who organized this stomp. I particularly like to thank the people that supported us in terms of sponsorship and different levels of support. And also, what we tried to do is involve students from the North Delta area. So we had a high school student show, and we also had students from Fondland College who were involved with us at least the first year. And then we also, and as mentioned in the video, part of what we made went towards the Delta Hospital Foundation. So again, it was a good thing for us to be involved in, and we really appreciate that connection. But thank you very much from all of the artists in North Delta. And our goal was to try and make people aware of the fact that we're in your community, we're living next door to you, and so this really reinforces that. Thank you.
As it is now time for the Rising Star of the Year Award. This award is sponsored by KPU, Polytechnic University. It's now my pleasure to invite the KPU representative, Marlon Graziano. Did I nail that one? Woo! I nailed it.
KPU is honored to present the 2016 Hats Off to Excellence Rising Star Award. We have lots of rising stars at the university, so this is very fitting. This award is intended to recognize an exceptional organization in our community, established in the last 1 to 5 years, that has proven operational success and growth, has shown innovation that sets them apart, and demonstrates future strong growth potential.
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Rising Star of 2016. Therapeutic Arts, one of many programs offered at Alongside You in Ladner. They also offer treatments like dialectical behavior therapy and therapeutic yoga, programs that fill gaps they've identified in South Delta. Individuals are welcome, so are couples and families. Healthcare at rates accessible to all, from Andrew and Meg Neufeld and the team at Alongside You. The North Delta Farmers Market was first 3 years ago, and Ann Jansen's been connecting great local produce and great local people ever since. Not just vegetables and fruit either. Next came the Tawasin Farmers Market, this year the Kwantlen Students Market in Richmond, and there are tours of real farms. Ann Jansen and Farm Fresh Events. What if the news coming to your door was all good news? 5,000 homes in South Delta? No. Something Good magazine captures the best of people and nature every month in South Delta. Sarah Kellaway has a decade of experience at community papers. Adrian McNair is an award-winning author and journalist. You may have noticed their splashy electric car in your neighborhood. Sarah and Adrian and Something Good. 1 year old next month. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Rising Star of 2016.
The winner is, and I've only met them on Twitter so far, Alongside You.
Wow. I had notes, but... First of all, thanks to everybody, and for the other finalists, Something Good and Farm Fresh. It's an amazing company to be in, and we're big fans. Thank you to the Delta Chamber and Louise Wexelberger. I've met you enough to know how to say that. Louise is phenomenal and has been instrumental for us in the first year, and so thank you so much. I won't take long, I promise, but I just wanted to say it is an absolute joy and honor to serve the community. Anybody who knows us knows we wear our hearts on our sleeve, and our focus is trying to meet the needs of people who may not be getting their needs met. And the support we've received from everybody here, lots of local businesses, has been really helpful. And the support we've had from the community has been amazing, and we just look forward to many more years. So thank you very much.
Next up is our Green Business of the Year Award. This is sponsored by Centivia Water Systems. I would like to invite Yvonne Anderson from Centivia to the podium, please.
Centivia Water Systems is proud to be the sponsor of the Hats Off 2016 Green Business of the Year. Now, green business, what is that? Well, we recognize a Delta business that has demonstrated strong consideration of the environmental impact of their products, services, or activities. They've demonstrated strong leadership in sustainability and green business practices and serve to inspire other businesses and organizations to be green. Centivia is a green business, so we love sponsoring green businesses. And this year's finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Green Business of the Year. By law, a mattress must be recycled, and there are lots of mattresses being brought here. Bed springs, because they are tempered metal, aren't easy to recycle. Box spring wood can be given away. Canadian mattress recycling started when the recycle law took effect in 2011, and they haven't looked back. This is their second larger location on Annecy Island. Tyrell Plotnikoff is the founder of Canadian Mattress Recycling. Things are busy down at Deltaport. CGT Global Container Terminals needs more space. They're rebuilding the whole place with a more efficient design. They already run green vehicles here, but new cranes will be electric, so less energy. No impact on nearby wetlands and habitats. The design will allow more work to be done safely away from the rail rack, and those electric cranes and high-mast lighting will reduce light and noise pollution. They will have 55% greater rail handling capacity on the same amount of land, and they are building this while they keep operating. Better LED lights for your business from Proven Energy Solutions. Founded 7 years ago in Ireland, Advanced Design Lighting for Businesses. Many local companies have retrofitted their operations. Brighter light, lower electrical usage, and an expanding range of fixtures that Proven Energy manufactures itself. In just over 1 year, Wasim Tahan and his team have built strong relationships with several BC businesses. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Green Business of the Year.
Center, it's my pleasure to present the 2016 Hats Off to Excellence Micro Business of the Year Award. This Micro Business of the Year Award recognizes a Delta-based business with 1 to 4 employees that has made significant business progress, is innovative, has a positive work environment, and shows strong growth potential. And this year's 3 finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Micro Business of the Year. Empower You is a workforce training company partnered with the American Hotel and Lodging Educational Institute. Customized training is offered for customers' employees from entry level up to executive level. And with Expedia Cruise Ships, offers seminars at sea. Empower You has been in business since 2013 and is headed by Joanne Gallagher Kurtzka. The chocolatier must not just melt the chocolate, he must temper it, heating, then cooling, then heating again and stirring, to crystallize just one of the 6 fats so that it not only tastes good, but when molded, the chocolate shines and snaps, or is formed into ginger, dark chocolate, raspberry with coconut, mocha, or white lemon. From chocolatier Lawrence Catterall and Ladner Artisan Chocolates. Every aspect of the medicine shop in Tuasson, they say, is designed with your health in mind. Healthcare products for sure, but time for thoughtful consultations too. And house calls. The pharmacist visits customers, often after hours, to deliver or administer medication, and sometimes just be a human contact at a lonely time in life. They'll do 12 or 15 home visits a day. Catherine and Paul Gibbons at the Medicine Shop in Tuasson. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Micro Business of 2016.
And the winner is Empower You.
large Delta Chamber of Commerce. Lots of large members here, and then small ones like a micro business. You all started like us. Thank you to the Delta Chamber again for making this available to us. Congratulations to all the nominees. I'm so excited and so surprised. This is for all of us. And to you and your organization, thank you for continuing to sponsor us. Please ask your friends who are not members of the Delta Chamber to join. It starts local and it works local. Thank you. Woo!
The Small Business of the Year Award. This award is sponsored by the Delta Optimist. It is my pleasure to invite Dave Hamilton to the stage. On behalf of Delta.
Good evening, and thanks again for showing up. The Optimist is very proud of its long association with the Delta Chamber, and in particular with this award. Small Business of the Year Award recognizes a Delta-based business with 5 to 49 employees that has shown considerable business success and expansion, delivers service excellence, and demonstrates strong community involvement. And this year's three finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Small Business of the Year. It's a welcome visit when the vehicle at your door has the Honeydew sign on the side. Honeydew's mission is to creatively keep seniors safe and successful at home and in their own community, supplying whatever each customer needs, being a help that each one can rely on. That includes exclusive discounts and benefits from other local businesses. Rhonda Dorham had her own grandmother in mind when in 2008 she created Honeydew Lifestyle Assistant. Perhaps you've noticed them in Experience Delta. Ladybug's Lifestyle Assistant, almost 5 years old now, provides help to new mothers and to seniors. Husband Mike offers handyman services as well. And a commitment to organizations like the Hospice Society and the SPCA. Anna Erickson and Ladybug's Lifestyle Assistance. The location, right here in downtown Ladner, is new to the new owner. Delta Optimist Reader's Choice Award winner. Today, Lawler Goldsmiths offers fine jewelry from an independent family business at attractive prices. Jewelry repair is a big part of the business, so is original goldsmith work and watchmaking. Patrick Lawler founded the business 28 years ago. His daughter Janice Lawler Cooper bought him out 6 years ago. Lawler Goldsmith Shop. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Small Business of 2016.
This year's Small New Business winner is Lawler Goldsmith Shop.
Thank you to Delta Chamber of Commerce for even having this event. And thank you for Delta Optimist for sponsoring this particular one. Wow, I just want to thank everybody. Most importantly, I want to thank my staff, because without my staff, I wouldn't be standing here. I've got Monique, Laura, Brenda with me. Stephen, Ramon, and Nels could not make it tonight. I also have my business coach with me, Beverly Rasmussen. So just thank you to everybody for this honor. I really greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
The second to last award of the night. It's time for the Large Business of the Year Award. This is sponsored by Guard World International Protective Services. I would like to invite Kevin Chandler to the stage from Guard World.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Guard World Protective Services, I want to relay that it is our pleasure to be a sponsor for the 2016 Hats Off of Excellence Large Business of the Year Award. The award is intended to recognize a Delta-based business with 50 or more employees that have reached a significant new level, established new technology, or broken into a new market. They have shown strong innovation in their business and have a positive work environment and have shown strong growth relative to their industry peers. And this year's three finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Large Business of the Year. Gordon Foods is not as quiet as it might look. The 9 p.m. shift is just warming up for a busy night. This is Food Logistics. Gordon Food just surpassed $1 billion a year in business. Foods you know arrive during the day and are being loaded onto trucks to ship tonight. Much of it is cold, refrigerated, or frozen. Gordon Food employees have raised over $200,000 for Habitat for Humanity. And Gordon's For a Cause program matches employee contributions to charities that employees choose. Food that leaves here tonight is going out to feed people in restaurants all over BC tomorrow. They'll fill and move maybe 100 trucks before daybreak. You want big? Ideal Welders has three buildings for big. Pipes and vessels. They're known for building big steel, getting it out the door and wherever it needs to go. Like the form pipe that would carry the ammonia to freeze the water for the Olympic bobsled track at Whistler. Jim Longo started Ideal Welding in the 60s, did a lot of work in forestry, and is still on the job running Ideal Welders today. And they've just torn the end off one of their buildings so they can expand it. The newer of two buildings at Marcon Metal Fab in Tilbury, cutting a composite with a jet of water, a plasma cutter. Innovation is one of the company's four core values. Metal Fab is growing as other fabrication shops in Canada close. Marcon does big stuff, particularly bridges. This will be the suicide prevention fence on the refurbished Burrard Street Bridge. Marcon raised over $10,000 for cancer research in the last 12 months. Ari Bernstein is the owner of Marcon Metal Fab. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Large Business of 2016.
Citizen of the Year Award, which has such esteem and history attached to it. This award recognizes an exceptional resident of Delta who has shown outstanding dedication and commitment to their community. Someone who has made a strong, positive impact in Delta and a source of inspiration, motivation, and encouragement for others in their community. And this year's two exceptional finalists are...
Ladies and gentlemen, hats off to the finalists for Citizen of the Year. Kay Dennison has spent 48 years in Delta, but retirement age has not meant retirement.
I met Kay about 7 years ago when we were looking to hire coordinators for the Delta Seniors Planning Team. Kay just spoke to what the project was all about.
So Kay has become the senior for seniors, advocating to make Patterson Park a village with an Alzheimer's center. Who'd have thought about safety for scooters? Kay did. A bump along the way with the Seniors Planning Team, but it was temporary.
Funding was stopped about 2 years ago. Kay decided that we are going to carry on and I will be the volunteer coordinator. And she has been ever since.
They've developed this medical information kit for every senior's fridge. But a real big issue is seniors' housing.
If you were to go to, say, Kennedy Senior Center, you would find that a large portion of their membership are former Delta residents who moved away from Delta because they couldn't find anything suitable to live in.
City Council got Kay and her people to do a major survey to quantify the seniors' housing problem. Kay advocates for many on transit, for the LGBT community, on many committees and causes.
When you think of the perfect Delta person, I think Kay embodies that.
Kay Dennison, a resident of North Delta, a citizen for all of Delta.
Yeah.
It is Grandpa Rick's turn to make sandwiches, and the whole family's pitching in. This is for Food on the Corner, the truck that for three decades has handed out food in downtown Vancouver.
I think he's got a lot of wisdom and insight, and I rely on him.
Rick's been on the Kin Village Board of Directors since 2012. We serve seniors providing housing, health, and recreation. Rick also chairs our nominations committee, which recruits new board members, and he's done a great job of continuing to bring capable people onto the board, partly because he has great connections in the community. He's been a fake fireman for our 35th anniversary last year. Rick will do anything that helps out at Kin Village.
Rick's a great Rotarian. Co-chair of the Soapbox Derby, chaired the big Rotary Conference for 500 in Whistler last year.
Hi, we're here at Rotary Waterworks at Diefenbaker Park. This was one of Rick Lewell's initiatives when he was the president of the Rotary Club of Tawaston in 2011.
At City Hall, Rick got a deal years ago for the history display. Is the chair of the Sports Hall of Fame at City Hall.
He was one of the founding fathers of the Hall of Fame 13 years ago, actually, and he's been a stalwart for us ever since.
Rick is an amazing person. I don't know where he gets the energy.
Rick Lewell, a resident of Tawasin, a citizen for all of Delta. Ladies and gentlemen, your finalists for Citizen of the Year.
Started, I'd like to thank the greatest Rotary Club on the planet, the Rotary Club of Tawasin. Thank you very much. This is indeed an honor. And you know, you think about this a little bit when you come in, and you don't realize how humbling this opportunity is when you come up on stage. And I'd also like to thank Kay Dennison. As well, she is sharing this award with me. She's also a producer. Thank you. You know, volunteering becomes a way of habit in this community, and I know our Rotary Club has, over the years, actually calculated the number of volunteer hours that are done in the community, and I know that this place is full volunteers that dedicate their hours, their time, their commitment to make this community a better place, and Delta is better for it. So thank you very much. Lastly, I'd like to thank my my wife, Carlene. She is my inspiration. She has given so much to this community over the years, and I'm just following in her footsteps. Thank you very much.
Okay, so that concludes our evening. I want to thank you all for attending. Drive safe. If you'd like us to call us a cab, please let us know. And have a great weekend. And I wish you good. Red nose, be careful. Well, you know, most importantly, be safe and keep others safe.